You know,
Harry, we're on the air.
Oh, quit. Hi, everybody, and welcome to the Hollywood Harry Sports Show. I'm, of course, Hollywood Harry. Joining me, Chuck Ecker. Chuck, how you doing?
Doing good, Harry. We got a great game today, huh?
Well, yeah, let's hope so. But we're doing something a little different here. We're in the parking lot at New Era Field. We're going to talk about the game before the game, and then after the game we're going to talk here. But beautiful day. These are the games in fall in New Era Field. I always want to call it Rich Stadium, this, that, you know?
Yeah. You know, we get 78 degrees today playing Tampa Bay. It's almost like Tampa Bay weather.
Yeah, it is. Just going to take my clothes off.
Okay? No, let's not do that, Harry. Right, come on, we're in Buffalo.
So, talking about Tampa Bay, really disappointed that Ryan Fitzpatrick's not starting. I mean, to me, that would guarantee a win.
Well, I don't know. He can throw 20 yards, can he?
He can also blow the game at the end. All right? I bet on this game before, on him before. Shouldn't say that. And he's pretty bad in the end.
Yeah, but Ryan Fitzpatrick's played for about six different NFL teams. He is that second or third string quarterback that they always go to. And remember, he's a Harvard graduate.
Yeah, he's smart.
Yeah, making a lot of money.
Another name you're going to hear a lot, Mike Evans.
Mike Evans, yeah.
Okay. You're going to hear that name a lot. That's his number one target. And, you know, Jameis Winston's a star. He was a top pick a couple years back.
Yeah, you know, he got hurt, and then all of a sudden he came back. He's going to be starting against the Buffalo Bills today. I think he's a great quarterback, up and coming.
Well, I think he is already. I don't think he's up and coming. He's had great games. And then, you know, in the NFL, I learned this last week. I heard the experts talking, and they said you don't know who's going to play good and bad week to week. You just don't know. You know, so last week, if you were betting, all the dogs won big games. You know, the Giants won, Pittsburgh won, Miami 17-0 halftime loses. So
yeah.
You just don't know every week who's going to play good and who's going to play bad.
In the NFL, you have to shut up and play the game. It gets to that point where you never know who's going to win on any given Sunday. Today it's going to be 78 degrees at New Era Field. We've got the Tampa Bay Buccaneers playing the Buffalo Bills. And what's going good with the Buffalo Bills?
What's going good? Well, they had the bye week. Do you think that'll help them being rested? That this early in the season this was necessary, or did it come too early? What do you think?
Maybe they get rested, or maybe they get a little rusty.
Yeah. Well, you know, the Bills' offense, it cost them the game against Cincinnati. You heard me say that, okay? We're hoping they get back on track. LeSean does his thing. We get Matthews back. Maybe they throw to Zay Jones 20 times today.
You never know what's going to happen. There's no wind. It's going to be a great sunshiny day.
Losing Charles Clay really hurt.
Oh, Charles Clay. Tell us about that Charles Clay loss.
Terrible, horrible. I mean, he cost them the game as far as I'm concerned in Cincinnati. But, you know, in the NFL, you got guys that are supposed to step up. This is their opportunity. Now, we traded all the receivers. Then the guys we got get hurt. So it is pretty thin. Let's face it. They're faced with a pretty tall task. They still got LeSean McCoy. They still got Tyrod Taylor, who, as far as I'm concerned, is as good a weapon as anybody. Because he could take off like nobody, you know? He's tough to bring down.
He's probably one of the best running backs in the NFL. Certainly.
Running backs or running quarterbacks?
Oh, running quarterbacks. I know, really. I'm telling you. So, we really don't have any wide receivers right now.
No, we don't. But you got to step up. This is a situation.
That means that our tight ends have really got to play. O'Leary.
Yeah, maybe Jack Nichols will be here today. Jack, we're hoping you're here. Root for your grandson.
Well, you know, the offense and the quarterback have really got to get better in sync. We need some more points. If we can score another 13, 20 points, we're going to be up in the top third of the NFL.
We aren't there yet. We know the defense is going to play good.
Yeah.
That's the one thing we're pretty sure of each week.
Yeah.
The defense has been stellar.
You know, we've got some good offensive players. It's really early in the season. We just had our bye week. What do you say we take it to commercial?
Okay, we'll do that. Okay, stay right there. We'll be right back. We are at Rocco 165 Monroe Avenue here in Rochester, New York. I'm with head chef and owner Mark Cupolo. How you doing, Mark?
I'm doing great, Harry. Good to see you.
Mark, you're going to whip up a couple of dishes here. Tell us what they are.
Well, we're going to do two of our dishes that we do here at the restaurant. One is a pasta puttanesca in cartoccio, which means baked in a parchment bag. The other dish is going to be a pizza that we do with ham and eggs.
Oh, ham and egg pizza.
Ham and egg pizza. Yep. Okay, so very quickly, the pasta puttanesca, I have par-cooked linguine here. You should use a long pasta, bucatini, linguine are best. A little bit of basic tomato sauce, a little bit of finely chopped black olive, capers, a little bit of anchovy, finely chopped, some crushed red pepper, good amount, spicy dish, and some fresh parsley. I'm going to put a little bit of what we made here is a garlic oil, just garlic-infused oil. Just mix that all together. Okay, so now we're just going to put this pasta in the middle of the bag, and we're just going to start to fold it from the edge, making a seal as you go. We're going to do a quick pizza, ham and eggs. So I've got the ricotta on the pizza, a little black pepper, a little bit of olive oil. Now this pizza, the only trick to this one is that you're going to bake it halfway, and then you're going to add your ham and eggs and finish it. You want a soft cooked egg, like a sunny side up egg, nice and runny, when the pizza comes out. Here's the finished product on the puttanesca. Then you're just going to take a little scissors or a steak knife, peel it open. Great method of cooking. You've sealed all the flavors inside.
Beautiful pasta puttanesca.
Once you open it, you can put a little parsley.
You pro chefs got a
little cheese.
Give it glamour.
And that's okay,
how about the pizza now?
And there's your pizza. Nice, all your white is cooked. Your yolks are very soft and runny, which is what you want, your ham.
Okay, there you have it. From Rocco on Monroe Avenue and Chef Mark Cupolo. Okay, everybody, welcome back to the Hollywood Harry Sports Show.
Harry, what did I tell you about drinking on this set?
Jesus.
I'm sorry, I can't help myself. Chuck, let's talk a little about the defense.
Mucka Hine.
Hey, Mike,
yeah, safety. Hey, I'm wearing a Hollywood shirt today, but our safety, you know, our defense is pretty good, Harry.
Defense is real good, okay? Couple guys coming back, couple guys on the injury aren't coming back. Gaines is supposed to be back. Johnson's back. Ramon Humbert's out. Charles Clay is out. We know that for the offense. But on the defense.
Alexander. Hey, we got Alexander. You know, we've got a great defense. We probably have a top 15 defense.
We hope we do.
Well, I think we will. It's still early in the season.
Here's another matchup today, and I have to say this. I think Evans is going to get have his way again with Tre'Davious White.
Okay? Yeah.
Because he's still young. He's not an elite cornerback yet. And look what they did to him in Cincinnati with A.J. Green.
Right.
So I feel that coming.
But you know what? You learn a lesson when you get burned like that.
Let's hope so. That's how you become a superstar, which I predicted he might become. And Shaq Lawson also predicted he would be a superstar.
You know, we've got some great players on our line. We've got good linebackers. We're getting better at safety. I think probably our safety is our biggest pickups of this year. I didn't think we were going to be as strong on safety this year as we are.
Well, nobody thought the Bills would be 3-2 going into this game.
There you go.
Okay, so this is a big deciding point this game. Where we go. Is it we going this way or are we going this way? We go on a big winning streak from here or we can go down. You know, defense has to play great, period.
A lot of football left right before Halloween. Jerry Jones from the Dallas Cowboys always says that it really doesn't matter until you get into the Thanksgiving weekend. So we've got some learning to do right now. Our coach is doing great. What do you think about our coach?
Well, I think he's got him in the right direction. Nobody thought 3-2, as I say. I like Sean McDermott. I hope he keeps going, you know. I mean, look, we liked Rex Ryan when he came here. Look what happened, okay?
Yeah.
Rex was the next coming of Jesus Christ. 2 years, we're running him out of town.
I think there's a big difference. I think you have a man who has discipline. He's got some great practices.
Discipline. How do you spell that word?
Yeah, right. We've got some great, great players that he is really molding. He wants talent. He wants community players that are going to be good in the community. They're going to have a stellar performance. They're going to have that attitude. Eagle Scouts, that's what he wants.
Yeah, that wouldn't be me. But, getting back to something you just said about Jerry Jones said it doesn't matter till November. Well, a reminder, Tom Brady is 56-10 in the month of December,
right,
when it really matters.
Well, for being an Eagle Scout that I am, Harry.
Oh, wow.
And a
co-host
of the show. You know, what we've got this week is a matchup between Tampa Bay, who is, as you say, an up-and-coming team, the Buffalo Bills, who really are trying to find themselves. But we've got some really good opportunities today.
If we can win.
Yeah, if we can score 30 points, I think this is our game.
30? We don't need 30 to win usually, okay? If the defense stands up like they do, we've won with 16, we've won with 20, you know. We don't need that much.
Well, I think we've got some things going today. We've talked about our defense. What do you say we go into our next segment?
Okay, folks, we'll be right back. Take a short commercial break. Be right back. Roof Roof. Everyone knows Greg the Roofer by now, but you don't know Greg works all winter long. Siding, windows, or roofs, Greg has financing for everyone. So call 585-727-0702 for a free estimate. But don't ask for Roofer. Greco's Furniture is announcing their largest sale ever. Oak, cherry, maple, hickory, and quarter sawn oak. Dining room sets, bedroom sets, home office, flat screen TV stands, and all season outdoor poly furniture. Now through Sunday, Jack Greco's for the finest in hardwood furniture. Be smart and go to sleep cheap for their back-to-school sale. How about a twin for $89, full $129, queen $139, king $179? And get free delivery with a student ID. Here's a queen pillow top set for only $299. With two locations to serve you, it's cheap, 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 cheap. If you like comfort food, you must try McGee's Country Diner. Located off Exit 41 on the New York State Thruway next to the Del Lago Casino. McGee's serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Friday, it's the fish fry. Saturday, prime rib. Use your casino points from Del Lago for your meal. McGee's has a dish for everyone. You must try the pig wings. So, for some real home cooking, come to McGee's Country Diner for some real comfort food.
Hi, I'm Monroe County Legislator Tony Michike. I'm running for mayor. I don't have the money my opponent has, so I have to go fast.
30,000 new jobs? Where?
We have the worst school district in New York State. Is this acceptable to you? Not to me. Do you really believe we are at a 30-year low in crime? Neither does anyone else. 45 years of the same people, the same party, the same failure. Have you had enough yet?
Okay, everybody, welcome back. Time for Talk to the Fans, brought to you by Jack Greco Custom Furniture. Jack is on Scottsville Road in Rochester, New York, and Inlet, New York in the Adirondacks. Jack says 10% off. Anytime you show up, 10% off from where you come from, and free delivery. I don't care if you're in Canada. One other reminder, our main sponsor, Greg the Roofer, is coming to Buffalo this spring. So if you want a free estimate, call Greg now. He'll be glad to help you out. So that's it. Let's talk to the fans.
Barry Decker from Boston.
And what's your question?
Well, the Beatles
my question
over
there? Today is, well, we need to know if this guy really knows how to play music, but I guess that's not a question.
Drums, no guitar, okay?
And I'm really wondering, you think the Bills can win today on my almost birthday?
What do you think? Can they win today, Barry,
well,
from Buffalo?
You know what? With the two weeks off, I think the Bills can do
anything
today.
Look at the camera,
today.
Barry. We're on TV. Okay, that's better.
I think with the off week and everything, I think the offense is going to come to life today. Special teams going to do it. The defense is going to score. And I think this game is going to be a heck of a game. And it's going to be a great birthday for me today.
All right. Happy birthday. Many more.
Hey, thank you very much.
All Buffalo.
Go Bills.
Okay.
Go Bills. All right.
I am Stephen O'Keefe. I'm from Fork River, New Jersey.
And what's your question?
My question is, how good is the Bills defense?
Look at the camera, Stephen. Okay.
The Bills defense, how good are we?
Great. Bills defense, that's all we got. We got no offense, let's face it.
You know, we've got the defense.
We're hoping and praying, but, you know, we don't see it yet, right? Yeah, you're a Tampa Bay fan.
Big Tampa Bay fan, yes.
What do you think? Tell us what you think of the Tampa Bay team right now.
The Tampa Bay offense, as long as we're on the right page,
we're
rock solid. We have all the offensive weapons to make this team great.
Defense is the problem?
Defensively, we're great, too, don't get me wrong. Maybe a little hair. A little bit better on our run defense.
What do you see happening today?
As long as Shady doesn't go off the wall, it could be a really close,
Mike Evans could go off the wall, too.
Absolutely. But at the same time, it could be a really tight, fun game that the fans, both home and in Tampa, are going to love.
Who do you like?
I think Tampa.
Who pulls this game off?
Tampa by
three. Because
you're
a Tampa fan?
Tampa Bay.
Get out. Thanks.
Steve from New Jersey, Tampa fan. All right, thanks, Steve.
Thank you.
All right, buddy. One. What's your name? Where are you from?
Rob from Webster, New York.
So what's your question? What do you want to talk about?
The question is, do you think the Bills will do any transactions before the trade deadline to make the offense better?
Trade deadline. That's October 31st, right?
I heard an inside rumor.
And what's that?
They're going to bring Peyton Manning out of retirement.
You
heard it first right here.
Who's he going to throw to?
Peyton.
So what do you think about our trade deadline?
I think I can definitely see Bolden. Everybody knows about Broncos are interested in a tackle of ours. Don't know who that tackle is. Cordy Glenn. for a potential wide receiver or just stockpile the draft picks.
Is there anybody else on the Bills right now that you think we could get some trade value for?
Right now, I think as far as trade value is concerned, we obviously don't have anybody to deal as far as from a running back or wide receiver
standpoint.
We already dealt them, exactly. I would say if you look at the defensive side of the ball, I think we have a little depth on the defensive line.
Great rock band in the back here, I'll tell you. You know, these guys rock.
Can't get value for one of the people we'd love to get value for, but we'll just have to wait and fight that fight another day.
What about offense trade? What do you think we should get if there's an option to get somebody new?
Yeah, without
question. Wide receiver, maybe?
Yeah, I also think running back. I think we've shown by releasing Barnyard, as I like to call him, it shows that we need help with the running back position. But wide receiver, I think we have the guy. I think he's on our practice squad. His name's any true Bills fan who follows this team knows Riley's out there and he's ready to play and he's ready to go. I think
might get a shot before you know it. You know?
Yeah, give him a chance.
This is everything today. We're going to find out who's a suspect and who's a legit.
Yep.
Who's your MVP right now?
I'd have to say on the defensive side of the
Jerry
ball, Micah Hyde. I love
Jerry
Hyde.
Hughes.
A lot of questions at the safety position going into the season, and I think we've addressed that.
Micah.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, fan from Rochester, New York, Webster, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen.
Okay, that's it for the first half of the show. Let's go to the game, and when we come back, we'll talk about the game.
Victory, Buffalo Bills.
Jack Greco's Furniture is announcing their largest sale ever. Oak, cherry, maple, hickory, and quarter sawn oak. Dining room sets, bedroom sets, home office, flat screen TV stands, and all season outdoor poly furniture. Now through Sunday, Jack Greco's for the finest in hardwood furniture. Here at Sleep Cheap, we have thousands of satisfied customers. Here's just a few.
I found this queen mattress at Sleep Cheap for only $399. Everywhere else in town, they wanted $1,000.
I shopped all over town for a king mattress. And I found the best value at Sleep Cheap.
I bought a great mattress for myself at Sleep Cheap. And while I was there, I bought a twin for my grandson for only $69.
With two locations to serve you, it's cheap, 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 cheap. Next to the Del Lago Casino. Use your casino points from Del Lago for your meal. Come to McGee's Country Diner for some real comfort food.
Hi, I'm Monroe County Legislator Tony Michike. I'm running for mayor. I don't have the money my opponent has, so I have to go fast.
30,000 new jobs? Where?
We have the worst school district in New York State. Is this acceptable to you? Not to me. Do you really believe we are at a 30-year low in crime? Neither does anyone else. 45 years of the same people, the same party, the same failure. Have you had enough yet?
Okay, folks, we're back after the game. What a game. Two words. Hausch money.
Yeah, nice field goal to win it, huh?
Unbelievable. Tyrod brings them down in the last 3 minutes. This doesn't happen usually at with the Bills. What's going on?
27-27 with a field goal. We win. Hey, the Buffalo Bills beat the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Unbelievable. A lot of good, a lot of bad out of this game, okay? The defense gave up a ton of yardage in the secondary. Jameis Winston threw for probably 400 yards or better. We're right out here after the game. We don't know everything yet, except we know we won because we just got out here. So, Hauschka did miss a field goal.
Yeah, he did. He missed that one. And we could have gone for that other field goal with a few seconds left.
Bungled that one. We don't know what happened. If it was the coach's call. We don't know these things yet till way later, you know. But it was a thrilling game all the way through.
Defense played well.
Defense played good enough to win.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you, that Jameis Winston, he is exciting.
He's going to be an all-pro one of these days.
They got a hell of a receiving core and all that, you know. I mean, but what a kick. What a thrill. What a game this was here. I wish everybody had as much fun watching it on TV as we did right here. Now, as we do every week, Roofer is a winner. He's not homeless. I think he won like 3,400 shingles. He's going to roll it over and bet everything he's got on the next game. Oakland, 30-24 Bills. That's Roofer's pick. So let's talk a little about Oakland next week.
Oakland's
got
a good
team. Most hated teams in all of pro sports.
Yeah. You know? Marshawn Lynch is not playing.
Darn it! Didn't we want him to come back? Yeah. Just like we wanted Fitzpatrick to play today.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Come on.
Former Bill.
Yeah. It'll be exciting. It'll be just like this week. And by the looks of things, I think they can beat Oakland.
I think so, too. I think the Bills are now showing themselves to be winners. They're 4 wins on the season. 4-2.
Who thought?
Yeah, this early in the season.
Who would have thought? So I think, as we talked about earlier on the show, Chuck, this was a game changer, this game. Which direction are they going with, you know?
Yeah.
And it's just, it couldn't have been a bigger thrill.
Well, I think the Buffalo Bills are on an upswing. Got a good coach.
We see that, you know. Tyrod played pretty good. Because, you know, we always got the Tyrod factor.
Yeah.
I mean, he ran for some big plays, you know.
7 years in the league.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's going to wrap it up this week. Hope you had as much fun watching as we did being here. Go Bills. See you next week.
All right, go Bills.
Roof, roof. Everyone knows Greg the Roofer by now, but you don't know Greg works all winter long. Siding, windows, or roofs, Greg has financing for everyone. So call 585-727-0702 for a free estimate. But don't ask for Roofer. Jack Greco's Furniture is announcing their largest sale ever. Oak, cherry, maple, hickory, and quarter sawn oak. Dining room sets, bedroom sets, home office, flat screen TV stands, and all season outdoor poly furniture. Now through Sunday, Jack Greco's for the finest in hardwood furniture. Here at Sleep Cheap, we have thousands of satisfied customers. Here's just a few.
I found this queen mattress at Sleep Cheap for only $3.99. Everywhere else in town, they wanted $1,000.
I shopped all over town for a king mattress, and I found the best value at Sleep Cheap.
I bought a great mattress for myself at Sleep Cheap, and while I was there, I bought a twin for my grandson for only $69.
With two locations to serve you, it's cheap, 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 cheap.
Next to the Del Lago Casino. Use your casino points from Del Lago for your meal. Come to McGee's Country Diner for some real comfort food.
Hi, I'm Monroe County Legislator Tony Michikay. I'm running for mayor. I don't have the money my opponent has, so I have to go fast.
30,000 new jobs? Where?
We have the worst school district in New York State. Is this acceptable to you? Not to me. Do you really believe we are at a 30-year low in crime? Neither does anyone else. 45 years of the same people, the same party, the same failure. Have you had enough yet?
All right, Eddie, thanks for coming on the show. Thanks, Shaq, for bringing him. Eddie, you've got quite the story. First, let's start with how you got here, okay? Tell us all the stops and starts along the way.
Well, you know, it's been quite a journey, but I started coming out of college. I came out in 2016. I got picked up immediately by the Denver Broncos. I got cut in the last round of cuts.
Oh!
Yeah. And from there, just started training. I was cold turkey, had no calls from no teams or anything like that. From there, I went up to Canada just to stay in shape, to get some reps and get some offensive tackles. Came back down, continued the same thing, just continued to stay diligent and keep working. And from there, I got one call, and it's from the Buffalo Bills, and come in for a workout, and the rest is history from there.
Roof, roof. Everyone knows Greg the Roofer by now, but you don't know Greg works all winter long. Siding, windows, or roofs, Greg has financing for everyone. So call 585-727-0702 for a free estimate, but don't ask for Roofer. Jack Greco's Furniture is announcing their largest sale ever. Oak, cherry, maple, hickory, and quarter sawn oak. Dining room sets, bedroom sets, home office, flat screen TV stands, and all season outdoor poly furniture. Now through Sunday, Jack Greco's for the finest in hardwood furniture. Here at Sleep Cheap, we have thousands of satisfied customers. Here's just a few.
I found this queen mattress at Sleep Cheap for only $3.99. Everywhere else in town, they wanted $1,000.
I shopped all over town for a king mattress, and I found the best value at Sleep Cheap.
I bought a great mattress for myself at Sleep Cheap, and while I was there, I bought a twin for my grandson for only $69.
With two locations to serve you, it's cheap, 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 cheap. Next to the Del Lago Casino. Use your casino points from Del Lago for your meal. Come to McGee's Country Diner for some real comfort food.
All right. Back with Shaq. Please welcome our special guest, Jarrell Worthy.
How you doing?
Tell us how you got to Buffalo.
Man, your
journey.
I was drafted 2012 to the Green Bay Packers. I was a second round pick. I was there for 2.5 years. I got traded to New England. I was out there for a short stint before I ended up in Kansas City for a year. I was out there for one season. I got cut there, and then Buffalo picked me up a little while later. So,
what was your opinion of Bill Belichick?
Man, whatever he is, what everyone says he is. I mean, like, he's a stickler, no nonsense guy. You know, he's all about, you know, demanding, you know, try to, you know, demand perfection or whatever. It's definitely a dictatorship over there.
Is it Sean a semi-dictatorship? He seems to be running a tight ship.
I mean, you know, Sean respects our opinion. He respects us as players. He respects, you know, how we come in and, you know, go about our jobs every day. And, you know,
we're all just learning, Sean.
Yeah.
You know, you guys are, and we are too.
Yeah.
Okay. We don't know him that well. Okay. So how was Green Bay? You're in the middle of nowhere. Did you like it out there or what?
I mean, it was cool. We were winning some games, you know, playing with A-Rod was cool. They have a great fan base like Buffalo. You know, so everything is kind of, things are kind of similar, between the two programs. And at the end of the day, there's a lot of history and a lot of tradition.
Yeah. Okay, you went to college at Michigan Spartans.
Michigan State, yep.
And I read your bio. The highlight was beating Ohio State.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. I mean, I have a few highlights. We had a lot of significant wins, but you know, being a kid from Ohio, going into the horseshoe. And,
were you an Ohio State fan growing up?
Yeah, I was.
Okay.
Yeah, so
didn't think about going to Ohio State, or?
I mean, you know, I did, but
isn't
that
what every kid dreams of who grows up there, though?
Yeah, it is. But you know, things happen, you know, one way or another, and you know, I end up, you know, going to Michigan State.
How do you like Buffalo?
I love Buffalo. I love the fans, love the tradition, love the fan base, and love playing with my guys up front. I love our defense, so, yeah.
We're doing that. Give me Rona, Sound King.